And a reminder of our movie premiere this Saturday at 10 o'clock is Terminator 2, James Cameron's action adventure thriller return starring Arnold Schwarzenegger. That's Saturday at 10 o'clock. Now here on Trevor 2, we're going live to Old Trafford for the Thursday's play of the Ashes as we go to join Trevor Nicholas for Trevor Match Special. Good morning and welcome back here to the Test Match, to the third day, a Saturday at Old Trafford. But it's not football, it's cricket, which is absolutely dominating the headlines. It's turning into a rather cracking Test Match as well, and the way this is poised, we're in for a real thrilling finale. Australia have a lead of 112 runs. They are 104 for 7 in their second innings. England all out for 198 in the end. Nathan Lyon taking 5 wickets, but Johnny Bairstow's 106. How important must that be when you consider the next best score that England managed was 24 by Sam Curran as well? Australia will be hoping to go get runs on the board and to make the chase tricky. And the one thing you could say here at Old Trafford is the chase is always tricky, and this is going to make for a thrilling game. Expect Australia to want to put 50 to 80 to even 100 runs on what they've got if the tail can really wag, and then it should be a thrilling game. If not, England will fancy their chances, and just remember, if England win, they regain the Ashes. Let's join Trevor Benno for the action. This promises to be a rather interesting day here of Test Match cricket. Australia's lead is there. Yes. And England will know for every run that Australia get, they'll have to chase that down. Australia are essentially 112 for 7 in the circumstances and beyond. Because after that effort by Peter Siddle, they're effectively now 116 for 7. Oh, he's kept up the pace here, and Archer has the wicket. It's his first fiver. And that is really well played, Archer. Thick inside edge, Butler takes the catch. That's great stuff. Cummings has gone for 11, it's 119 for 8. Australia's lead is 133. And Nathan Lyon just sat there and flicked the ball off his pads to take the ball down to Schultz's fine leg here for 4 easily. His foot is perilously close to stepping on his own stumps though, but won't matter. Australia know that they really have got to produce something special to win from here. Oh, Anderson swung that late. I wonder. Umpire's unmoved. England did appeal though. And they've challenged straight away. Jimmy Anderson is convinced. James Anderson has gone to his skipper and said that's out all day long. Twice on Sunday. Umpire was unmoved. Peter Siddle here.
perhaps goes a bit early to play this block, misses the line of the ball, and it's clipped the pads. But he's got a long way across the stumps. I think this is going down leg. This will be the key moment. And I think you can see here, it's going to miss leg. Anderson is annoyed. Siddle survives. Close one by Moen Ali. England need more bowling like that. Oh, Peter Siddle. Stunning. Just have a look at this. Look at the way he shapes his body to scoop the ball away. Big appeal. I think Siddle's got to cross the line again. Not out again. The Lancashire crowd is getting frustrated. England haven't reviewed this. So let's see what would have happened if they did. They would have lost the review. Good decision not to. And it's Archer's 18th over here, and while he's keeping the pace up, his line's wobbling slightly, and Nathan Lyon takes that away, and these are all runs England have to get. He really wanted to skittle the Australians over quickly. It hasn't happened. Australia are edging themselves into a potential lead here on a deteriorating wicket. Would be something to see Australia win from here. Really would. Archer appeals this. I think another one. Leg bounce. Not out again. It's the fourth time they've been turned down this morning, England. Oh, good captaincy by Joe Root. He brings in the leg slip. He gets Peter Siddle. Ben Stokes has come on. He got both openers in the first innings. He's got Siddle here. That is a really good catch by Burns. England have Siddle out for 34. It's 166 for 9. One wicket to go, and Australia's lead is 174. That's out. That is out. Six wickets here. Archer has wrapped things up. The extra bounce that he generates has done the business this morning. Nathan Lyon, I think you're a goner here. Now Edjo has it. Thick edge. Hotspot reads the same. There's the nick. It is pace that can do the difference here at Test Match Cricket. And it's Archer who's lighting up this Test Match. Australia all out for 166 in the end as well. Good work by Peter Siddle and Nathan Lyon, matching the scores and beating that of Tim Payne and Usman Khawaja as well. Australia's need 174. England need 175 to win. Well, there was once a famous run chase in Australia many years ago. Australia needed 175 and Dean Headley Mastercast blew them away. England know that on this time they're chasing down a small target. They never made it easy in the past. Bold! Roy is out. Cummings here with this in-swinging Yorker that does for him. That's just what Australia needed. Well, there's real zip and belief in the Aussie bowlers here in the field. Yep. Burns plays that really nicely through cover. His first boundary, his first runs. It is set up to be a brilliant day's cricket now. Rubbish. Yep. Absolute rubbish, and has got the treatment here. Wide and full, a real full toss outside leg stump. A score for those any day of the week. And Burns went, thank you very much, I'll have a boundary, please. There's Josh Hazlewood, the closest thing to Glenn McGrath Australia has produced. Big afternoon required by them. Oh, what a perfect start. Joe Root has edged that to Bancroft that's caught it. Hazlewood's come on, Glenn McGrath-esque. England have lost their second wicket. Four slips and a gully. There's the outside edge. Bancroft comes across, take one step, catch. You can see there the little nick. And Joe Root here has either got big scores or no scores. He's ending this session with a no score. Bancroft here took a very comfortable catch in the end in front of Khawaja. And England now are 23 for 2. They just don't make things easy, do they, England? Anyway, Johnny Bairstow has found things easier than most batsmen today. And off Hazlewood, he's found the boundary. Good for that. That'll be over the fielder. One bounce for four. Johnny Bairstow is still playing his shots. Unorthodox, but runs. There's another one. When it's full like that, Bairstow's going to cash in. For England to win now. 8 wickets for Australia to take. Oh, that is nicked over the wicketkeeper by Bairstow. And he has found the boundary. And no wonder Mitchell Stark looks annoyed. Bairstow trying to give it that slap, if you like, right the way through to Gully.
Yep.
And Mitchell Stark there with his fastest delivery of the day. At chest height, and Bairstow has stepped back and has placed the ball, and a no ball as well. So England will have 5 runs off that delivery. Yep. Into the gap. And 4. Stark annoyed here, but it's really well done. Just good cricket, that is. Just good cricket. Oh, Lyons made a difference. Big appeal by the Australians. A little nick and the finger goes up. Nathan Lyon with 5 wickets in the test match. Old Trafford is famous for spinners doing well here. Misses Laker and Warne and Panesar and company before can remember. England are now 70 for 3. And when Stark's bowling that way, Bairstow is looking really comfortable playing the ball, as shown here.
Yes.
And Stokes is off the pair. And he's got a boundary. And here is a man who is capable of chasing down a target like this. And I'd love to see him still here. A half century from somebody you feel down this order might just do it for England today. 88 to win. Out! Bairstow's gone three short of a half century. Nathan Lyon's done the business again. His second wicket. His seventh of the match. Edged here. Bancroft takes the catch. Out for 47. England are now 87 for 4. And they're over halfway here, England, in this chase. But they've lost four wickets. Yep. But Butler and Stokes, that World Cup final partnership, gave England real hope. One wonders they can continue to do so. Nice bit of batting there by Butler. How they need him to fire. Well, Nathan Lyon is really up for this. Really G'd up, and he's had the best of Ben Stokes in the series. Yeah, he's got him. Ben Stokes cannot score here against Nathan Lyon. He's tried to step down the ground, and Ben Stokes has demolished his off stump. Lyon's third wicket. Bowled Ben Stokes for 10. It's 100 for 5. 74 for England to win. Lyon getting ready to take on Butler. And he's bowled him! Oh! Well, how about this? Butler has gone. A beauty by Nathan Lyon, who was making inroads to England. Oh, there's Moeen Ali, and that's four. Well, England will definitely want more of this here. Well, look at this by Cummins. Here's the effort, and Moeen Ali here turns and knocks that away nicely. ...61 to win in a session. 35-0 was potentially available. And Moeen Ali with an excellent cut for four. With Sam Curran and Moeen Ali at the crease, England have a chance. Wonderful 100-run partnership at Lords that gave England hope. These two have got the ability to bat, and they need to bat well here. There's a lot rests on that man. Hazelwood to continue to Moeen Ali. And runs again. Well, when Australia have bowled wide, England haven't hesitated to take it to them. Game is completely in the balance at the moment. And we'll take it. 47 runs to win. Australia still need to find four wickets. I think we're getting closer and closer to a really special finish here, the way this game is going. Old Trafford are doing their part to keep everybody going. That's in the air. That has got away. That has gone all the way. And it has found the boundary. Four signaled by umpire Gould. Moeen Ali here played it high. Heart in your mouth, but it's just wide of the man's square, and there's four more. Oh, fantastic by Sam Curran. Really heard the rattle of the bats, and that made a really good connection. He hit that really hard. 36 now, four wickets. And it's safe, it's bouncing and rolling away. Four more! England are edging closer and closer and closer here. Yes. It's into the gap. They will run two here though. And it's good running, really good running. More importantly, that is a 50 partnership. Well done, folks. It's just what England needed. Australia have got to break this partnership here if they are to have any chance of winning this. Peter Siddle here. What can the old vet do? Fantastic! Peter Siddle has broken the partnership. England are in trouble. Australia are in the ascendancy. Great catch by Steve Smith at third slip. This game swings like a pendulum clock into Australia's favour again. Mitchell Starc here, eyeing up Archer. Man at square leg, a third man, a deep fine leg as well. One slip. England going to run. The throw's at the other end, and I wonder if Archer's gone here. Tim Payne with the throw. He's gone. He has gone. That is an absolutely brilliant, brilliant bit of cricket from the Australian captain. Fantastic run out. Elected to go to the bowler's end as opposed to the wicketkeeper's end. And it has bowled Archer, and Australia are getting closer. 154 for 8 now, England. 21 for win. 2 wickets. This is getting closer and closer. Moeen Ali into the gap. 4 more. That'll ease some nerves here this evening at Old Trafford. This is just such drama here in this test match. Oh, again, Moeen Ali. 13 to win now. 2 wickets for Australia. Have a look at this. Mitchell Starc. Perhaps Australia are going here and looking for the wicket as opposed to sticking to their plan. Looking for line and length. Oh, broad ducks, and that flies over Bancroft. And that runs through. England need 8 to win. Aussie need 2 wickets. By signals. England don't care as long as they get those runs. Oh, Starc will be annoyed. You know broad's no good with a bit of chin music. But he's going to be backed up by his wicketkeeper. 8 runs to win. 2 wickets to take. It is perilously tight. All the hallmarks here of Edgbaston in 2005. Siddle in into the attack again. Caught! Out! Moeen Ali! Peter Siddle's done it again. At third slip, Steve Smith again. Moeen Ali's played so well, but he's gone. And England are 8 short. Australia need 1 wicket to win. And here comes James Anderson, the Lancastrian at Old Trafford. He's saved a test match before. He could win it. England need 8 more runs to win. And that's a good block. That's a good block. 1 wicket for Australia to win. 8 runs for England. This is so close. Well, Pat Cummins has been brought in here by Tim Payne. Broad at the moment is on a 10 ball duck. And England are going to run into the gap and get one. They've got one. It's down to 7 to win now. Well, when Australia are going to bowl it wide, England have got to cash in. Like that, Jimmy Anderson has done really well. Plays it into the gap. Gets another single. There was a famous line, England getting it by singles. 6 are required to win. 1 wicket to win. Oh, this is close. Stuart Ball does really well, and England have got to run. Got to run really quickly. Both dive home. 5 to win. 1 wicket to take. Peter Siddle to continue here. Stuart Broad plays that into the gaps. There is a fielder there. But England get home. England need four. Australia need one. Oh. What's going through your mind if you're a bowler? Do you bounce it? What about your line, your length? Can you hit the stumps? Into the gap as well, and it's going to go past the man at square leg, Peter Hanscombe. England get home again. Three required now. It's Edgbaston 2005, but the roles are reversed. Australia are never usually the winners at these close test matches. Stuart Broad's played that into the gap as well. This could be an opportunity if England can run home as well. Broad is home. Anderson is home. Two to win now. Oh, this is unbelievable. We could even have a tie. We could even have a tie. Oh, the change. Peter Siddle. What do you do here? Anderson and Broad. 4-2 respectively. Just one to tie. England think about running as well. That's good fielding. That's good fielding. Steve Smith comes in and that's how things stand. England couldn't get the run away. And Pat Cummins is in. Every person praying here. Can England find one run? Here's Cummins. Oh, there was a little nick. He's given him out. Out. Australia win the test match by one run. You will never ever see anything like this in test cricket again. Stuart Broad with the nick. Catch by Bancroft. It's incredible. Absolutely unbelievable. The Australians are going crazy and they have every right to. Edgbaston has been avenged. The memories of those tight defeats are now memories, because when it really matters, Australia have won. England here had one hand on the urn. Australia ripped it off them. We're two apiece in this series and it is all to play for, and Australia are back in the Ashes. Oh, it was something else in the end. Australia winning this test match by one run. Absolutely incredible as well. Nathan Lyon's 4-for-12 was deadly, but Peter Siddle's 2-for-30 as well. An Englishman needed someone to get a half century and take them home. We were so close to a tie. We were so close to winning the room. But it is the closest ever finish that there's ever been in Test cricket.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I scarcely can believe it. Australia win by one run. It is the closest margin of victory in Test cricket there has ever been. It is unfathomable to think that after all the overs and the 3 days that we've seen in the field, every ball that's been bowled, every run that's been scored, that it has come down to the very last moment of play, and in the end Stuart Broad nicking through to Cameron Bancroft, Pat Cummins celebrating, on Australia winning by one run. England needed just one to tie, and that would have taken it to Old Trafford, and that would have taken it to a decider as well. England just needed two to win, and they'd have the Ashes in their hands. But as things stand at the moment, Australia have levelled the series at two apiece, and it is going to be decided at the Oval in 2 weeks' time. Join us. We're there, where we hope for another thrilling game of cricket, but maybe just a different result. We'll see you. Bye-bye.